Hello everyone, this is Kelly Beard of KarmicTools.com, and this is your weekly forecast for November 22nd through the 28th of 2020. So as promised, I did a special eclipse update that has an audio and a video, but I also realized I forgot to do the Scorpio Energy of the Month post. So that's here where the post or the audio, you can listen or read. And I went ahead and posted the Sag Energy of the Month as well, where you can listen or read. And the special eclipse update has a video posted here along with an audio if you'd rather listen than watch. So let's dive in. Our first activation is on Monday, Mercury trining Neptune. This energy activates your creative process and intuition. You may catch yourself unconsciously drifting aimlessly, but a better use of this combination is to open to the other realms for ideas and information and play with it. Free flow, see where it leads. It is not the time for pragmatic analysis, but more a time to explore the infinite possibilities available to you, as well as what's going on in your own consciousness. You may be more sensitive than usual, opening yourself to information or awareness that isn't always that readily available. Remember to keep good boundaries when opening like this, and if you have to be around people, try to maintain the mystical creative vibe that this energy is best for. Then it moves to the 27th, which is Friday, Mercury sextiling Pluto. Then this week it's going to sextile Jupiter, and then next week it'll sextile Saturn. So it's doing its final round with this crew before they leave Capricorn once and for all for many years to come. So a sextile is an opportunity to gain some traction. Mercury's finally out of the retrograde and the challenge is there, and it is creating some clarity. Pluto is the transformation part of getting deep with it and really tuning in with your soul first, and then going to Jupiter and expanding what's possible so that you can go forward next week with Saturn and anchor it in some kind of reality or make it real or give it a form or a shape or give the flow a structure, right? So that it's useful and relevant and helpful for others as well. So the kickoff on the 27th with Mercury sextiling Pluto first, this energy provokes the need to delve deeper into the ideas or information being presented at this time, whether personal or professional. So I would also say this combo back to back of trine Neptune and then sextile Pluto, very good for divinations and communing with the angels, ancestors, and animal spirit guides. Really good for that. You will want to dig deeper and ask the hard questions and gather insights that are basically deeper and more profound than usual for you. In your professional or public life, you may find yourself doing better due diligence. And in your personal private life, you may find yourself digging a little deeper into your own mental patterns and personal history, which has led to now. As you make these connections and begin to grasp these new insights, they will gain traction and you will become more grounded in your own truth, your own authentic truth. We all get excited about these kind of aha moments, and you may find yourself wanting to share them with others who may or may not actually be ready to hear such deep truths or have the conscious awareness to even process them. So use some discernment around who and when you share these newfound insights. Deep breath. Same day, Friday the 27th, Venus is going to oppose Uranus. This is always a special one to pay attention to, because anytime Uranus is involved, it becomes the wild card and hard to predict how things will unfold. But right now, there is definitely a push-pull between your apparent values and your unique individual self. Venus also represents relationships, so you may begin an unusual relationship or you may have something unusual happen in an established relationship. It is not necessarily a good or bad thing, as much as an unpredictable shift or sudden awareness, which requires some compromise and integration. This energy works beautifully if your personal truth and values are in alignment. It will be very disruptive if they are not. So be open and flexible while looking for the win-win situation for all involved. Okay, so Venus wants happy units. Uranus wants to shake things up. Internally, Venus is a personal planet. Uranus is a collective planet, so we look at this personally right now. And where I said there's a push-pull between your apparent values and your unique individual self, what's happening is we're outgrowing certain aspects of our being. And Uranus is always the one to kind of provoke us to look into that and honor it and not disregard it or dismiss it as non-essential because we are changing in some very essential ways. And if you can co-create with it, it's less disruptive to those who love you. The 28th is Saturday, when Mercury will sextile Jupiter. So after we do some deep diving, we get to come here. Where Sun sextile Jupiter is more about you, this activation is more about your consciousness, ideas, thoughts, and concepts, Mercury's domain, which Jupiter expands in some way, helping you to think bigger, edit your personal story, and step up your game in some kind of way. This is also a great energy to work with if you are in school, learning something new, expanding your knowledge base, or gathering tools and information to support your goals. Your dreams are tapping you on the shoulder right now, demanding some attention. Mundane issues are not your concern with this energy. You want to figure out how to create the life you've been imagining. This energy also provokes within you the awareness and understanding that being generous naturally attracts generosity to you. The big picture and overall patterns which have led you to this point are being brought into the light. Feeling clear, sharp, alert, and optimistic, you begin to realize that anything you can imagine or remember, you can achieve. So, deep breath. That's a big one. Mercury's your own mind and consciousness and ideas, thoughts, and concepts. Jupiter, of course, is expanding that. And this is the perfect time to be thinking bigger. It's so perfect. Then we have the final thing for this week, Neptune going direct in Pisces on the 28th, on Saturday. So if the moon represents the individual womb, then Neptune is the collective womb. When it retrogrades annually, we are given an opportunity to consciously develop something, usually related to healing and wholeness. The retrogrades always encourage us to go within and heal, make whole, or integrate something critical to our own well-being. What healing have you been working on personally since June of 2020? Neptune is most commonly known as the planet of dreams and visions. So on a normal day, Neptune creates the desire, the daydream, create, visualize the ideal outcome to life, a relationship, or a project, etc. It tends to see everything through rose-colored glasses, putting its hopeful spin on it all. So when it retrogrades, it may be less shocking than Uranus or Pluto, but no less effective. Its primary goal during a retrograde is to gently dissolve personal boundaries. You start to realize your connection to the whole. Not a bad idea, but to some, it can be unsettling if they are rigidly holding on to boundaries for a false sense of security. Hopefully, you've been able to reconnect to your spirit in a way that helps you navigate in the world better going forward now that it is direct. So, Neptune goes backwards every year and gives us a chance to kind of check in with our spirits and that department, Pisces. It's there for 14 years, and I believe it's only about halfway through. So, deep breath. That's our week. Very juicy for dreaming and doing some things that probably American holidays make challenging to do. But if you can, make some time and space for yourself to do some divinations or have some sacred time, maybe shamanic journey, meditation, anything to open up to your deeper self for the answers of what's next, what needs to be expanded and what needs to be consolidated. Is all part of this. And definitely if you need some extra support, the Scorpio Sag energy of the month and the eclipse supplement is all going to be really fun to dive into. And I hope it supports you and I hope you have a fantastic week. And I so appreciate you being part of my community and taking the time to listen to these updates. I appreciate each and every one of you and feel free to reach out if you are called. And I'll talk to you soon. This is Kelly Beard of Karmic Tools signing off.